Democrats are looking at what happened in 2020, where Joe Biden's margin over Donald Trump on with Latinos was 7%. That's compared to 27% for Hillary Clinton just 4 years earlier. So is this a golden opportunity for Democrats to get the policy right and the politics right on the issue?
It could be, but we were just talking about how progressives are really happy about all of the things in the infrastructure bill. They are really being led in many ways by the progressive wing of their party, and the progressive wing of the Democratic Party does not want to go hard against Cuba, against some of the things that the Castro regime may have been a part of, in part because there are some Democrats, there are some progressives who agree with some of those things. They agree with universal health care. They agree with some of the programs that were in place in a more socialist kind of society. And Joe Biden is trying to push against that. He's essentially trying to say, you know, we do not want our party to head in that direction, because he saw what happened in South Florida in 2020, right, where, mm-hmm, you know, he did very much worse than Hillary Clinton, and Democrats really lost a lot of ground, in part because Republicans are pushing this message that all Democrats support socialism and they support the kinds of policies that will make the United States a third world country. Some of that was hyperbole, but it resonated with a lot of the voters there, and Democrats
are trying
to figure out how to.
And where in South Florida, where just like in Cuba, there have been protests in the streets this week in support of those protests, and one of the dynamics to your point about Democrats is the progressive members like AOC versus members like former Congresswoman Debbie Mercastle Powell, who lost her seat,
yes,
to a Cuban American over this issue.